Hello students, in this video we are going to discuss about RBI DPR for 2021 phase 1. That was on 6th of March. Here we are going to discuss about what sort of questions were there, what was the difficulty level of the exam, and we will have a look about the previous year cutoffs. Coming to the level of exam first, let's see what sort of paper was there. In the previous video also we have discussed that about 70-80% exam will be of numerical pattern. The paper was as per the expectation that it was basically numerical based exam. But coming to the difficulty level, the students find it moderate to difficult. Some of the questions require rigorous calculation. That is why actually the paper was found quite lengthy and it was found difficult for the students. But yeah, it was as per the expectations only that the 70-80% of the paper was numerical part, and yeah, it requires lot of calculation. If you are preparing for DEPR and you are planning to prepare for DEPR, you should be preparing and focusing more on the numerical parts. Let's see about the sequence of the subjects. Yeah, it was actually the same. Like there were questions from the micro, there are questions from the macro, there are questions from the stats and econometrics. Okay, so basically it was actually the same pattern they are following, that they used to cover the paper in three parts. The first part is micro, then they used to cover the macro section, then it was all about the stats and eco. Okay, so there are few questions from mathematical economics too, like some Leontief and matrix notation questions were there. Those were under the mathematical economics section, and we have to cover all these things. Coming to the number of questions from each section, coming to first the micro, there were 23 questions from the micro. And what topics were there actually? There are questions from market and general equilibrium, there are questions from demand and supply, numericals basically from demand and supply. Under the demand and supply, there are questions from elasticity of demand, then there are questions from the substitution and income effect. Okay, so this was from the demand and supply. From market structure, if we talk about, there was a question on Carnot model, and then there are also questions from cost analysis. Here actually in the micro, the production functions and all are also covered in the micro section. So yeah, there were questions from the production section. There are basic questions, some easy questions from the consumer surplus. There are questions from Pareto optimality also. So it was from some welfare economics. So this is from the mathematical economics. So there are questions numerical from the Leontief matrix. And this is again, you can say from welfare economics also. So there are questions from externality. So coming, if you are seeing what sort of question was there from the elasticity of demand. So it was like you have to calculate elasticity of demand at a given price and quantity. And it was actually the 4-marker question. Okay. From cost analysis also there was a question from minimization of cost. There are actually some few basic questions related to the marginal cost curve and average cost curve was also there. From production function, there is a question from Cobb-Douglas production function. Like micro, there are 23 questions from the macro part. Basically each and every aspect from macro was covered. The question mainly were from the national income accounting. There was a question for calculation of the primary deficits. There are some questions related to the shift in ISLM curve. And then again, there are questions from the Mundell's-Fleming, that is from the open economy. There is a question from Phillip curve, that what is the shape of Phillip curve related to that. There are few questions related to the calculations of the multiplier. Multiplier based calculations questions were there. Then a question from adaptive expectation was there. And another thing was, yes, there is an infant industry argument question was there. Question related to BOP, theoretical based question was there. And another thing was, there is a question from money supply, that what happened, what are the factors leading to decline in the money supply. So this sort of questions were there. besides that, there were numericals actually based from national income accounting. Basically, numericals were there. Then, if we talk about the calculation of multiplier, was there. So, basically, it was also numerical based. If you are preparing for DEPR, you should not only read the theory, you should also practice for the numericals. Besides, there are so two questions from public finance. Then, there is a question from terms of trade. There was a question related to risk premium. There was calculation related to inflation rate. Again, one thing was there, actually, it is always suggested to read the economic survey and the budget for this portion, because you not actually many questions, but yeah, few questions usually were asked, but not that much of weightage. These 2-3 questions might be there from the current affairs, but this time there was actually no single question from this portion. The students who have actually attempted the paper, I suggest then don't get disheartened, because this will be a plus point for you while you will be answering your in the phase 2 portion. So this will not go any ways. Don't think like that. It will be very helpful for you in the phase 2. These are the few topics that were covered from the macro part. Coming to the next and the third part for the paper, that was stats and econometrics. There were 16 questions from this part. 2 questions were 4 marker. And coming to the topics that have been covered in the statistics and econometrics, first of all, there were actually most of the questions were from the covariance and correlations. From the covariance, actually, a sort of question was there that you have been given the covariance of A and B. And then you have to calculate the covariance for A plus X upon B, say Z. And then you have to calculate about B plus Y upon V. You are given this covariance, how you are going to calculate the covariance for these variables. So how you are going to calculate it. So this type of question was there, and there are questions. Another thing was there are questions from the regression analysis. Then there are questions based on the calculation of the t-value. There are questions from the binomial distribution. There are few questions from the probability. Then there are questions from the autocorrelations and heteroscedasticity. When we talk about autocorrelation, the Darwin-Watson test is always so important, and there was also a question related to that actually. Besides that, if we go what sort of questions were there from correlation and regression analysis, so it was like you have been given standard deviation for X, you have been given the mean value of X, mean value of Y, and some more information was given to you, and based on that you have to calculate the value of Y when you already have the value of X. So some sort of questions like that were there. And another question that was actually there, that was actually on the same line that we have discussed in the doubt sessions. Exact value was not remembered actually by the students, but the exact same value for the question, but the pattern was actually same. For example, if the 10 pairs of value of X and Y was there, and you already have calculated the regression line, and then you came to know that no one pair actually was noted wrong, that the value for X was not 3, it was actually rather 8, and the value for Y was not 8, it was rather 3. So in that sort of case, how you are going to recalculate the correct regression line? So in this line, these are actually the quite important question, and this question was actually asked in the 2 marker. And usually for this type of question, you have to calculate few values, like you have to calculate the value for sigma square for Y, and you have to calculate summation XY, you have to calculate value for summation Y square, like that. But these value were already given to you, and you had to calculate the corrected value for each of these variables. Then using that corrected value, now you have to calculate the correct regression line for this correct pair. Okay, so this type of question actually was there, and it was already covered in the doubt class of ours. And most of the questions actually the student find are on the line of our mock test. So coming to our main question that students are asking about, that how much, how should we score? Because actually the paper was actually quite lengthy considering the numericals, actually mostly considering the 2-marker numericals, because they were quite lengthy, and based on that actually students were left with actually less or no time. Okay, so paper was actually lengthy in that sense, and based on that students are quite worried about how much we should score to clear the cutoff. So how much the cutoff is going to be this year? So actually the previous year cutoff, if we see, was it was actually high at the initial years, but now it's somewhere around 52. Okay, for the general category it is somewhere around 47, for the OBC categories and for 35 to 45 from the last 2 years, for the SC category, and same for the ST categories. Okay, so this was actually a bit same. Okay, so coming when we talk about cutoff, actually it is somewhat relative, said what sort of questions are they are usually it varies depending upon the relative performance of the students in the paper. So if you are if the paper is so good, the cutoff can go high, because most of the students might secure quite high marks. But if the marks secured are not that high by all the students, so cutoff is going to be low. So for this year, you can considering the difficulty level and somewhat, actually the cutoff might vary from 45 to 50%. But yeah, again, as we know, next exam will be on 31st March. There will be a paper 2 and paper 3 that will be in descriptive nature. In spite of worrying about the cutoff, we'll suggest you to prepare for phase 2. Worrying cannot improve your cutoff, but while worrying about the cutoff, you might lose 2 or 3 most important days of your life. In spite of worrying, then let's just prepare for phase 2, because it is the next step that you should be worried about. This is actually the crucial time, and as the exam is on 31st March, you should be focusing on that, because the result might announce in a week is actually in the air, that it might be announced in 2 to 3 days actually. So in spite of worrying about the results, prepare for the phase 2, because it is going to be much lengthier paper and you require a lot of preparation for it. Basically because the paper is of descriptive nature, and yeah, the part will be economics, and besides that you also have to cover the descriptive English portion. The paper will be of 100 marks each. For phase 1, the 100 marks was there. For phase 2, 100 marks for economics, 100 marks for descriptive, then 50 marks for the examination. These 350 are going to be the final total for the basis of your selection. This has already been cleared, but now your focus should be on these 3 parts. Okay, considering the subject background, you might be performing very good in economics, but yeah, you need practice and practice for this portion also, and you have to practice for the descriptive English. Descriptive English is always a game changer for these types of exam, so prepare for that. Our platform provides DEPR online courses, in which we are providing the mock test, we are providing the videos and study notes. Besides that, we are taking the doubt clearing classes. Paper and the mock test are actually in the line with the set pattern by the RBI. It is exactly the same, so it will help you in preparing for the exam, because it is exactly in the same pattern the exams are conducted. So for example, if you are preparing for phase 2 for descriptive English, you have to write the exam online. How we are going to help you? We are going to provide 5 mock tests to you. Descriptive English, you will be typing your answers on your screen, and then you will be sending it to our expert. Then experts are going to evaluate your paper, and based on that you will be knowing how much you are prepared for phase 2, and they are going to help you out in improving your strengths, and will be focusing on your weaknesses to increase your marks in the exam. For economics, you do not have to type, you rather have to write the paper. We are providing the mock test. The question will appear you in on the screens, and seeing that question, the timer will be set for 3 hours, and for that you have to take a pen and paper, you have to write down your answer, then you will be getting 15 more minutes to convert your to scan your copy, to convert it into the PDF form, and then you have to upload it on the site. Answer sheet will be evaluated by the expert and you will be getting the feedback. Then you will be knowing that what sort of answer you should write and what under what topic, what should be the points that you should cover. But in this slide, we are going to help you out for the preparation of phase 2. So if you haven't buy the course, go buy it for preparing for the phase 2. And if you are planning to prepare for DEPR, then do buy the course, because it will help you in the next year. We have expert faculty who help you out throughout your exam. They will be guiding you. Besides that, the descriptive English, that is actually the game changer. You can practice that for phase 2 with the help of our expert faculties. Okay, this was all from iExamB. All the best for your exams. If you are preparing for another exams besides DEPR, go check on our websites what are the courses available and start preparing today for it. Subscribe to our channel if you haven't and press the bell icon for more updates and notification. Thank you. All the best for your exams.